Hi everyone, how are you my dear children? Hope you all are fine, safe and healthy. Okay, in my last lecture children, we have discussed speed and I am hoping ki you have understood that lecture because it is easy only. So today we are going to discuss what is velocity. Very easy. What is speed of the car? Speed of the car gives us the idea how fast the car is moving or how slow the car is moving, but it is not giving any information in which direction car is moving. Okay, so when we are telling ki I am going from Mumbai to Kolkata, then with this much of speed, like 70 km per hour, I have started traveling from Mumbai with 70 km per hour and we went towards Kolkata. Then I am giving a idea about in which way my car is moving. Okay? And this velocity, this speed, sorry, with the direction is termed as velocity. Nothing great with this. Simple. So what is velocity? Velocity is nothing but the distance traveled by a body per unit time in a given direction. So velocity is equal to distance traveled. Okay? Divided by time taken. Clear? And you will write it as V. Or you can write V as S by T. T is the time taken, S is the total distance travelled. But in velocity, you will not write the distance travelled, rather distance travelled in a given direction. There is particularly one direction will be given, either you are moving towards north, you are moving towards east. There will be some idea in which way the object or body is traveling. So distance travel in a given direction, what does it mean children? We have already studied in my first lecture, please go through that lecture. Distance travel in given direction is nothing but displacement only, children. This is nothing but displacement. So displacement by time taken is your velocity. Hope I am clear with this velocity term. Okay, then tell me what is the SI unit. Same, displacement meter, second, kilometer or hour, centimeter per second. So either meter per second or kilometer per hour or centimeter per second, just like your speed. Clear? Now tell me, is it a vector quantity or scalar quantity? We know speed is a scalar quantity. But in this case, that is the major difference between speed and velocity. Here we are having what? Direction. That's why we are terming it as displacement. That means it is giving you not only the magnitude but also the direction. So that's why velocity is a vector quantity, children. It is a vector quantity. Clear? Okay. So, this is your velocity. What is average velocity? Same only. What is average velocity, children? Average velocity is nothing but total displacement by time taken. Okay. What is average velocity? What is average velocity? This is nothing but total displacement divided by time taken. This also you can write. Okay? Suppose average velocity is given and time is given. Can you find out what is the displacement, what is the total distance traveled? Displacement will be average velocity into time. Is it clear, children? Very easy, very simple children. Average velocity into time. Or you can say S is equal to V into T. As V is equal to S by T. Is it clear? We are going to use all these formulas in numericals, children. Another way to look at average velocity. What is that? If the velocity of a body is always changing, but that change is in uniform rate, children. Okay? Then what is your average velocity? Average velocity will be nothing but if the change in velocity is at uniform rate. The velocity of the body is changing. Velocity is changing at uniform rate. Okay, already I have discussed what is this uniform thing. Okay, uniform rate. Then the average velocity is given by nothing but normal mathematical mean, that is arithmetic mean of initial velocity. Average velocity is equal to initial velocity plus final velocity, because uniform. Okay. Final velocity divided by 2. Hope I am clear with this. Okay. Now we will try to understand what is uniform velocity or constant velocity, as we have studied in case of speed also. I have discussed that condition also. What is uniform velocity or constant velocity? What does it mean? Let me light in full. Okay. If an object traveling in a specified direction, in a particular direction, in a straight line, then what will happen? It will move same distance in every second. Then only you will tell your velocity is uniform. Okay. So that means a body will have a uniform velocity if it travels in a particular direction in a straight line when it moves equal distances in equal intervals of time. Okay, children? Clear? This thing I have discussed in case of speed also. I have given example also how it will be uniform speed. Same way here only you have the direction. Now can you please tell me how you change the velocity of a body? How to change? Okay? On which factor your velocity depends? How to change the velocity? If I want to change the velocity, what I should do? How to change the velocity? One way you can do, change the speed. Change the speed. Then obviously your velocity will change. Okay? Or what you can do? Suppose speed is constant, still your velocity can change. How to change? Just changing the direction. Change the direction. By changing the direction, also you can change the velocity. Is it clear, children? When the body is not covering equal distances in equal intervals of time. Okay, children? When body is in non-uniform motion, then what will happen? What will happen? If body is not in uniform motion, what about your velocity? Tell me. Velocity will be variable, children. For non-uniform motion, for non-uniform motion, velocity is variable, not uniform only. It will change. Clear, children? That means body is not covering equal distances in equal intervals of time. So speed is not constant, but then obviously velocity will not be constant. It will change. But if the speed is constant, okay, if speed is constant, then also velocity can be variable. If speed is constant also, velocity can be variable if we change the direction. Clear, children? Okay. Now one more thing. Can you people tell me the speed and velocity are always equal in magnitude? Let us see. Try to understand. Is speed and velocity, speed and velocity, is always same? Is it always same in magnitude? I am talking about magnitude, children. Always same in magnitude or not? Tell me now. Very easy. I think people know all those things. People are smart. Okay. Suppose I am here. Okay. I am standing over here. This is my house. I am standing over here. I have to go to my friend's place. This is my friend's house. Okay. My friend is staying over here. Suppose distance from my friend's house and from my house to friend's house is suppose 100 meter, children. Okay. And I went to my friend's house to cover this much of 100 meter of distance. Suppose I have taken 50 seconds. Clear, children? Now tell me, and suppose it is in east direction, because this is north, this is south, this is east, this is west. Suppose it. That means I am moving towards east. Okay, children? Then speed will be how much? Speed will be how much? 100 by 50, so 2 meter per second. What about the velocity, children? Tell me. What about the velocity? Again, displacement by time taken. Okay. So, 100 meter towards east divided by 50. So, it will be again 2 meter per second but towards east. See, the magnitude is same over here. Okay. So, here what we are observing, if the body is moving in a straight line, then speed and velocity remains same in terms of magnitude. Only the value will be same if body is moving in a straight line. Speed and velocity both are having equal magnitude. But if you not move in a straight line, then we'll see now how speed and velocity are not equal. Let us now see that important one. Okay? Suppose same thing I am going to consider. This is my home. I am over here. Okay. This is my friend's home. He is over here. Okay. And 100 meter in 50 seconds I have taken to reach here. Okay. Then after meeting my friend, obviously I want to come back to my home. So what will do? Again, I'll first went there, reached my friend's house, have a nice chat, we had a fun, then I came back. Okay? Not having fun inside the house, there itself. Okay? That means, leave that also. You do, no, after having fun, I don't want to come back. Then I am going to take another example. Okay? Because I am determined now to show you how the magnitude can differ both speed and velocity. I told you please run towards your friend's house. I'll keep the timer. Okay. You please run towards your friend's house and immediately turn back and reach here. I am having now a stopwatch. I'll record the time. You told okay. Granted. I accept your challenge. Then you ran towards your friend's house. That means you have covered your 100 meter distance in 50 seconds and with the same pace also you have returned because you are very smart. So you have returned like this. 100 meter again you have covered and you have taken 50 second time to reach again at the same place. Then in this case, tell me what is the speed. Please children, what is speed? Total distance travelled by time taken. What is the total distance? 100 meter this way, 100 meter this way. So it is 200. What is the total time taken? 150 second plus 50 second. So what is the speed over here? It is now 2 meter per second. Now let us see what is the velocity. What is velocity, children? Velocity. What is velocity? This is displacement by time taken. What is the displacement now? You went there, again returned. So displacement is final position minus initial position. What is the final position minus initial position? Zero only. Is it clear, children? It is zero. What is the total time taken? 100 second and 0 meter. So what is velocity? 0 meter per second, children. See here, speed and velocity differs. Why? Because it is not moving in a straight line. You have reversed the direction. Is it clear? When you are traveling in a circle also, started at this point and reached over here. So what is the displacement? Displacement is 0. So what will the velocity? Velocity will be 0. But there will be speed. Total distance. Suppose it is having radius r. Total distance by, suppose time taken is t. So this is going to be your speed. But velocity will be 0 since the displacement is 0. Hope I am clear with this. That means the average, or you can say the velocity and speed, may not be equal in magnitude. In which case, it is not moving in straight line. Hope I am clear with this. So what is the clear cut difference between the speed and velocity? Speed is nothing but total distance traveled by your time taken. What is velocity? The displacement by time taken. Speed is scalar, but velocity is vector quantity. Speed, what? Speed can never be zero. Otherwise, how will you get to speed? Speed can never be zero, but velocity can be zero. Your average velocity of the moving body is zero over here, children. Hope I am clear with this concept. If any doubt, please leave a comment in comment section box. Okay, children? Hope this lecture has helped you in understanding the concept of velocity. In my next lecture, we are going to discuss acceleration. Okay, children? Please take care and focus while studying. Bye, children. Thank you for watching.